Hey, welcome to Fix by Doc, and what you're looking at today is our new solar panel that we have to run the water pump system for our sprinkler system for our back garden back here. And it is the Coleman. Well, let me flip it over so you can see the English side. The Coleman 18 watt solar 12 volt battery charger kit. And here's the back side of the panel. 18 watt solar panel for 12 volt battery systems. And it comes with these connectors, this charge controller, and alligator clips if you want them, and this connector for our solar water power or solar powered. A sprinkler system. This is the connector we're going to be using, and we use this basically this exact same solar panel, only an older model. It's the same solar panel. It's just an older model that we use for our electric fence, and it works just great. This is the new model of the same company, same solar panel, just a newer model, and it has. What's different between the one that we have for the electric fence and this one is the framework. They have a new track system with these pieces here. So I'll have to read the instructions to see how these work. And I may or may not use them for mounting the solar panel, but if they're going to work for the way I'm going to be using it, then great. If not, it doesn't really matter. There you have it. So I'm going to go ahead and get this all hooked up and connected to the sprinkler system, and we'll show you what it all looks like then. Okay, so here's the battery that I'm using for the sprinkler system. This is the 12 volt, 18 amp hour battery here. And it's one of the ones that Hurst Replace One gave me. And what I've done is, because I have two things that need to plug into these battery terminals, but I've only got one battery terminal for this battery. And they're the blade terminals, I guess is what they're called. So I took a female blade that plugs into the male blade on the terminal, and I set it up with two wires, as you can see, that come out to two males, and that'll allow me to plug solar panel into this one, or I mean charge controller from the solar panel into this one, and the water pump into this one, and then this into the battery. And so now I have two terminals on the battery, and these are from the charge controller there. And then, where are they? Those are from the water pump. And then there's the solar panel there. And the solar panel is giving me, where's the? Oh, there it is behind me. I'll show you what the battery is right now. Oh, can you hold the camera for a second?
Can't get a good grip there. Okay. I think I can see what you're doing.
I want to show this here. So the battery is currently 13.7 on the charge. So, and now I'm going to show you what the solar panel is bringing in, and I'm connecting it to the charge controller. So without the charge controller, it's bringing in about 21. With it on the charge controller, bringing 18.4, and if you look at the solar panel, it is in partial shade, so it's pretty good. It is an 18 volt solar panel, and so once it comes through the charge controller, it's bringing in exactly what it should. Okay, so here is the battery installed with the water pump hooked up and the charge controller up installed. You can see the light on saying it's charging and all that good stuff. So it's all good. I have the water controller turned off at the moment. And when we're done mowing, Addie's running the lawnmower at the moment. When we're done mowing around the garden area, then we'll turn the sprinkler system on. It's easier to mow dry grass than it is to mow wet grass. So, and I currently have the solar panel leaned up against the fence right here. Right up against there for now. I think before we leave, we'll just see. I think that'll be fine right there. And we go ahead and put this lid locks into place there so it won't blow off or anything. It's got locking. It's a locking lid with the handles on the sides that click in. And it seemed to hold up to that hailstorm that we had nicely. And, alrighty. Put these back in a bucket. And, okay. I've got some other stuff I gotta take care of. And, we'll get back to you shortly. Alright, well, this is rather disappointing. The three head sprinkler system, which came in a kit, doesn't work as advertised. It says a 50 PSI water system is sufficient to run it. I have a 50 PSI pump hooked up. So it has the water pressure, according to the package, it has the water pressure necessary to run the system. And I've got them adjusted according to the package, the way it said to adjust them to maximum burst. So I'm not seeing a 30-foot radius that these are giving. Each one of these sprinkler heads is supposed to spray out 30 feet. And even if I turned them all off except for one, I'm still not going to get much more than what you see here. So that's disappointing. So I'll just pick up some different ones from Lowe's. And the hose line and the whole system is fine. I'm just gonna go and get the ones that sway back and forth like this. And try those, get the name brand ones. I tried to go with the generic version from Walmart and they're pathetic. So, in theory, it was going to be good. And on the package, according to the package and everything, and the picture and all that other stuff, it looked nice and glorious, but apparently it doesn't work. So, alrighty, no big deal. They weren't hardly expensive at all. To buy these little sprinklers by themselves, it's only like $2 or $3 per sprinkler head. The main deal here is the hose and all the connector pieces and everything, which do work. So, and that's fine. Because the timer and the hose and all the connector pieces is what I needed for the system, and all that does work. It's just the sprinkler heads itself don't work. So we'll pick up a different sprinkler head and hopefully those will work. So, all right, no big deal. It's only like $6 and some change. So if I remember right, these little if you got buy them separate from the package deal, they're like $2 a piece. So we'll get a different version and take it from there. So, all right, there you have it. At least we know the rest of the system works. The rain catches works and is collecting water and sending it to the pump. The pump is pressurizing the water and sending it to the timer. And the timer is sending it to the sprinkler heads. We just need more efficient sprinkler heads. The solar panel is charging the battery. And here the water tanks are collecting water. We do need to put the agitators in to agitate the water. And we do need to come up with a cover for the tops here. But I'm going to take some of the black felt that you put on the garden to keep the weeds from growing through. I'm going to cut some black felt large enough to put over as a lid and then take a bungee and wrap it around and hold that on. That should keep the light out. And when it rains, it should allow the water to fill the barrels from the top via a permeable lid. But it should also keep the bugs and mosquitoes and stuff out. And may not even need an agitator then. So, got the rain catch repaired, with the exception of need to replace that T-post over there in that corner, but we'll get that done when we go to Lowe's tonight. And everything's back to basically the way it was before we left for our vacation. Plus, we have the sprinkler system completely installed now. And we will go and get the new sprinkler heads done. So, okay, there's today's work. And while I've been working with the garden, getting the rain catch redone and the watering system done and the wiring and everything, adding mowed around the garden and mowed the pathway down to the woods. And now she's scraping the bottom of the lawnmower. So, and then Addie and I weeded the garden. She did most of the weeding in the garden, but okay. So, alrighty. Thanks for watching. Anything you want to say?
Good to go.
Okay. Talk to you later.